Hi, Rebecca.
Hi. I heard you wanted me to talk about a space-time dreaming example.
That's right. Thanks for coming.
Hi, everyone. I'm interested in hearing Rebecca's example, too.
That's great. Actually, I was going to sit down and listen. So I'll just sit back and listen to both of you.
Okay, sounds good.
Okay. This example has to do with a supervision session I did with a facilitator. She wanted help and advice about her conflict situation that she had facilitated recently.
I'd like to hear about that.
She was a very good-hearted woman. And she spoke about a situation that she felt she hadn't done too well with.
I know what that's like.
Right. Okay, the group she was working with was having a conflict about a difficult social issue. I'll keep the exact details private to protect the identity of those involved. There were two basic roles in the conflict. On one side were those who were trying to be understanding about the issues. They had a gentle sort of energy which our facilitator felt she could relate to and work with. Let's call this the U energy.
Okay.
She had more difficulty with another role, which was very angry and had a very intense type of energy. Since this role was difficult for her, let's call this the X energy.
Okay, I got it.
She said there was one particular person who was very angry on the X side of the conflict, who she felt she didn't deal with very well. And she wanted some advice about how she might have done better with them. She said she tried to use some of the first training skills that she had learned, but in this situation, she didn't feel she could use them well. And because of the stress of the situation, at times she couldn't even remember those skills. So, this was a moment for her second training.
So, what did you tell her? Or what kind of supervision did you give her?
Well, to make a long story short, I first acted out the angry person and asked the facilitator to show me what she actually did with that person. She said she tried to be very kind and understanding. As you can see, she held out her hands in an understanding gesture. Her head was slightly down, and she said, with a soft and kind voice, "Oh yes, I understand you." However, to her surprise, this only made the person who was angry even more furious.
They weren't touched by her kindness. So, how did you help her with this?
Well, I encouraged her to take a bit of time to explore space-time dreaming. That is, to relax for a moment and let the spaces around her move her about smoothly and also a bit unpredictably. And as she moved, she noticed the energies of both roles arising. At first she made gentle motions, and then, as her movement became more unpredictable, she moved in a more intense and jagged way, even with clenched fists. She said that she sensed both energies in her dance, and this helped her feel into them more deeply.
What happened then?
I then asked her to try to stay in touch with her space-time dreaming experience and see how it might help her facilitate the situation. So, once again, I began to act like the person who was angry. Again, she tried to approach me in a good-hearted way, but it didn't touch me. So, I reminded her to stay close to her space-time dreaming experience and let it bring her insights as to what to do.
I'm curious what happened.
It was actually very moving. Of course, each of us would have our own unique insights and way of applying them. This was her way. So this is what happened. Well, she meditated for a moment. And then she suddenly hit her own chest with her fist. And with intensity and anguish, cried out, "I'm in pain. I feel the pain."
Wow.
At the same time, she reached out to me still playing the angry person, with her other hand. And, in that moment, I felt deeply understood, both emotionally and energetically. And, at that point, we grabbed hands with one another and both sank to the floor, feeling the pain and agony of the situation. And that was behind my anger. It was a very touching moment and the beginning of a further and deeper dialogue.
I'm touched. So can you tell me how space-time dreaming helped her really touch and get through to you?
Well, her space-time dreaming dance made it possible for her to open up and feel into that very intense energy, which was so different from her ordinary way of being. She was able to sense the X energy as a natural part of her universe dance. And her dance gave her spontaneous insights about how to relate to the other person.
How did that insight come about?
I wish I could tell you that. When you're in your space-time dreaming experience, it brings you insights that you can't necessarily track with your ordinary consciousness.
That's interesting. But, I thought what she did was pretty unusual. I don't know if I could facilitate like that.
That's okay. As I said before, what you learn and the insights that arise from your experience of space-time dreaming will show you your own unique way of facilitating and using any of your other first training skills.
I like that. I'm going to think about it for a while.
I've been listening, and I have a couple of questions, if you have time.
Sure. Go ahead.
Okay. What you've been talking about sounds to me like the idea of compassion. Is that right?
Well, space-time dreaming gives you an even deeper sense of compassion. That is, compassion not only for the sides and energies that you like, but also for the sides and energies that you have trouble with. Or don't even agree with. Of course, as we've mentioned many times in the film, this doesn't mean that you shouldn't be one-sided sometimes. But when things aren't working well, this can help. That is, especially knowing the energies rather than solely focused on the content. And this makes it possible to speak even more deeply and authentically for all of the various roles.
I guess people would trust you more as a facilitator.
Yes, that's right. I should add that this also stresses the inner work of the facilitator. Because a facilitator can only miss something with a client or group if she is missing it in herself over time.
Huh. I hadn't thought about that.
The facilitator I was supervising is not sufficiently intense. So all of this is really part of her personal development as well.
I see. That gives me a lot to think about.
Great. Okay, I hope that gives you and our viewers at least an introductory idea about space-time dreaming. There's a lot more to say, but I think we should close now. The next and last section is actually the conclusion of the film.
Oh yes. I heard that Sally Rue will come back with some of our narrators to summarize some of what we've learned throughout the film.
That's right. And they will give us an idea of where our world work studies and practice can take us in the future.
Great. I'll see you there.
Okay. I'll see you there. Bye for now.